Once upon a time, many years ago, there was the project of a small keypad. But we never completed it. So, we left you no possibility to replicate it.
Since we are working on a couple of long-term projects, we didn't want to leave you without a video. So we decided to complete the keypad project and release all the related files.
Without further delay, let's start, just after the theme song. Welcome back. We know that there are a lot of similar keypad projects on the internet, but our goal was not to copy other projects. Instead, using our vision and our thinking, we wanted to create something unique, and at the same time, we wanted to understand and learn how the things really work.
We will now introduce the last version of the keypad, analyzing its three main aspects: the hardware, the software, and the firmware.
Let's start from the hardware. Our choice was to use a modular structure made of three PCBs, designed to be adjusted for different configurations. This means that anyone can choose to arrange the PCBs in the way he judges to be the most appropriate. Like this, or this, or this. Your fantasy will be the limit. In the first video, we created prototypes using the Ant, milling the controller and the keypad boards. Thanks to this, we found a bug, and after solving it, we sent our corrected design to be manufactured by PCBWay, our super sponsor. Looking at the relative simplicity of the encoder board, and knowing about the grid service quality offered by PCBWay, we decided to send this PCB straight to manufacturing without making the milled prototype. As usual, we just had to go to the www.pcbway.com site, and in a few clicks we were able to order this new set of boards. As a matter of fact, the info we need to manufacture a PCB are the dimensions, the quantity of boards we want to be manufactured, the shipping method we want to use, and we could leave all the other interesting settings to the default values, or we could change them as we like. In our case, we decided to use the red color for the board with a white serigraphy. Then, in the following phase, we just have to load our design files, pay the order, and that's it, it's done. The design files you loaded will be reviewed. Then the production will start and you will be able to follow the process evolution. Moreover, I don't know if you noticed, in the PCBWay site there are new manufacturing services that we want to try as soon as possible. Anyway, all two three boards are quite simple. The controller board contains an Arduino Pro Micro, a small OLED display, and two buttons to have the possibility to choose a custom preset for different application programs. The keypad board contains 8 keys, 8 anti-ghosting effect diodes, and a connector to connect the controller directly or using some wires. And the new super round, super beautiful encoder board has an SMD rotating encoder with a low profile and all the passive components needed. The case containing these three boards could be made in so many different ways, according to your own needs and preferences. We decided to make it as you see, taking in account that we will use the keypad with the left hand and we will use the mouse with the right one, since we are right-handed. You will find everything related to this hardware in the repository in the description. Let's talk now about the firmware on the Arduino board. we would have liked to use MicroPython, but since we had already chosen this microcontroller, we opted for the Arduino code. The integrated development environment that we used is VS Code with Platform IO plugin, and we liked it quite a bit. It seems better if compared with the Arduino IDE. The firmware itself is essentially divided in two parts. The first one takes care of the keys management and the keyboard emulation, while the second one deals with the writing reading of the presets and the keys using the serial port communication. In addition, the firmware has some fancy features, like the animation when we change the preset program on the OLED display, and a small library that manages the encoder using just one pin interrupt. To read and write application presets from and to the Arduino, we could have written a small sender program that just sends a config file with the shortcuts. Obviously, we chose the hardest way, and we spent our sleeping hours designing a graphical user interface that made the keypad configuration simpler and funnier. This interface is tested just on Windows at the moment, but in theory it should work also for other systems. Even the interface is divided into parts, one for the serial port connection and the other one that allows to create the whole application preset settings. The user is able to set the shortcuts for all keys using an automatic grab system. It is possible to assign 11 keys combinations, 8 for the keys in the keypad, and 3 for the encoder, for right rotation, left rotation, and the push button. In this small demo, you will see how it's easy to update the configurations. We can connect the configurator to the keypad using the serial connection. Then, we can read all the existing key configuration for the various applications, and we can observe the actual shortcuts used. If you want to change one of these combination of keys, we just have to select it and then press the new key sequence. The software will automatically grab the new shortcut. To test a new shortcut, we have to update the configuration on the keypad pressing Update Programs. To make the new configuration permanent, we have to store it using the right programs on EEPROM push button. You will find in the repository the source code of the user interface written in Python. What we learned from this project is that a correct integration of its three main parts, hardware, firmware and software, is required for a successful outcome.
Of course, this project is in a beta version and could have some bugs.
We like this keypad. We had fun building it, and we hope you like it too. Tell us what you think about it.
We know we don't produce so many videos, but when we do, we try proposing to you something interesting that you could enjoy as much as possible.
And also for this reason, we ask you to help us by subscribing to our channel.
We say again thanks to our very kind sponsor, PCBWay.
See you next time. Ciao!